Hi guys, Virtus Education here with episode 2 of the Cryengine 3 SDK tutorial series. And in this episode, I'm going to be showing you how to download and install and set up your Cryengine 3 SDK ready for the rest of the series. So having said that, if you want to download it, go ahead and go to the My Cryengine website. You can even just quickly copy this from the browser here, which I've got here, or alternatively you can just go ahead and click the link which I have in the description. This site is really brilliant. You can check out all the different technology and so on and so forth which you have in Cryengine 3. However, for now we're just going to go ahead and use it to download the engine. While the engine is downloading, you can check out some of the stuff which you have on here, because the file is 2 gigs, so it may take a couple minutes, so you know, you have a couple minutes to go ahead and browse it. So just go ahead and press the blue download now button and it will take you to the crydev.net website, and just go ahead and press download the free SDK. Now keep in mind, you can actually see a version number here, 3.5.3. now keep in mind, if you are watching this maybe a couple months or years after I've actually created this series, there may be a few slight changes with the engine. However, those changes probably aren't going to be too significant, so hopefully you should have the ability to just follow along regardless of these slight changes. So just go ahead and press download the free SDK now, and then just go ahead and press the download now button. If it is not doing anything right now as I am when I click it, just go ahead and right click it and press open link in new browser, and it should start downloading pretty much immediately. Now while this is downloading, as I said, go ahead and check out some of the stuff on the Cryengine website, you know, the features and so on and so forth. Make sure that you do meet the minimum system requirements for this. Now I'm going to quickly pause the video while this downloads. It's going to take about 5-10 minutes for me, as it is 2 gigabytes, so I will get back to you in a moment. Okay guys, so I pretty much just finished downloading the engine. Now once you've done that, just go ahead and open it as per as I said previously. If you did actually go ahead and check out some of the links and stuff and so on and so forth on the website whilst it was downloading, you'd be highly impressed by some of the stuff that Cryengine has done. Anyway, so this is going to be finished downloading in about 10 seconds for me. Now overall, this download didn't take me too long. I believe it took me about 5 to 10 minutes in total, seeing as my internet speed's relatively good, and hopefully you should be able to do it in about the same time. Now just go ahead and open this. This is a zip file, so you're going to have to go ahead and extract everything you've got here. So first of all, I advise that you create a new folder to actually put all this stuff in. Now you don't actually have to give this folder a specific name. However, I do advise that you name it something like Cryengine and put it in a place where you can easily find it again. Once you've done that, just go ahead and drag all the content here that you have into the folder. It shouldn't take long, maybe about a minute or so, depending on your hard drive speed and whatever you're doing in the background. So it's probably gonna take a bit longer for me, as I'm actually recording and so on, which is actually raping my hard drive. However, in the meantime, I advise that you just go ahead and register on the crydev.net website. The reason for this is because you're actually going to need to sign in when you launch the engine before you can actually use it. It's kind of a pain, however, you know, it's just their security, and security is everything. Yeah, security is good. So to do that, just go ahead and press sign up or register in the top right hand corner of the crydev.net website. Scroll all the way down. If you want to, you can read the terms of agreement. However, you know, obviously it's just blah blah blah, don't screw anything over. However, hopefully you should be fine. Go ahead and press agree, type in your info as per normal, and just go ahead and press submit. You might be asked to verify your email or something. If it does, just go ahead and go to your email inbox, click the email, you know, click the verification link, and you should be fine. Once you've done that and your engine has finished extracting, go ahead and open up the folder and go into bin 32. So hopefully it should finish for me in a couple seconds. There we go. So once you've done that, just go ahead and go into bin 32, and then from there we gotta look for a very specific file. Okay, so that specific file that I mentioned in the bin 32 folder is editor. Now, you should be able to find this pretty easily. Once you double click and open up that, you will actually get into the engine. It's simple as that once you've extracted it and so on and so forth. Now, I believe there is also a 64-bit version of the editor in the bin 64 folder. Now, only use this if you actually have a 32-bit version of Windows and hardware. Once you open up the engine, you will be asked to log in with your crydev.net username and password. This should be pretty simple, and just, yeah, enter exactly what you did before. So I'm just going to quickly pause the video while I enter my information, and we will go from there. Okay, so I just finished entering my information, I pressed enter, and now once we close all this crap, you know, we will actually get the engine up, and this is what the engine looks like. It looks pretty nice, sweet, and yeah, so just go ahead and play around with some of the different stuff you have in the engine, ready for the next video in which we go over the interface. One thing I can show you for now is just go to File, Open, just go to Single Player, open up the forest level, maybe just explore, go through some of the different bars and so on and so forth that we have for available to us. But for now, this is pretty much everything we need for setting up the engine. If you do get any errors or anything like that, the engine's not working, please let me know, or don't forget to check out the documentation, Google it, and make sure that you do have it working. However, if you did indeed follow the procedures that I mentioned, you should be fine. Now, loading levels may take a little bit of time as you know, the sizes of the levels are relatively large. Not in scale, but rather the file sizes. However, if you do, and you get in there, you should see these rather nice scenes. Now, these scenes look pretty sexy and so on. You can press Control G to run around and play around with them to experience them fully. But yeah, comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.